Good morning, students. So the second part of the human transportation, yesterday's, let us continue. So first of all, yesterday you have seen the heart structure, and this structure is only for explanation, not for the examination. So this will be the left side. This will be the left side of the heart, and this will be the right side. So not to get confusion, when you stand like this, then this will be the left side and this will be the right side. Okay, as I told you yesterday, there are four chambers are there in the heart. So upper both the chambers are called auricles, and lower both the chambers are called ventricles. So naturally this will be left auricle, this will be right auricle, this will be right ventricle, this will be left ventricle. Okay, now these are the chambers of the heart. So auricles also called atria, and ventricles, ventricles only. Then these four chambers, why it is needed yesterday, as I told you, to maintain the body temperature. To maintain the body temperature means, now you see, first of all the chambers are separated. Here in between this one septum is there, okay. So this is separating, all the chambers separating septum. So auricles and ventricles again separated with the help of valves. These are valves. Okay. So what kind of blood will be there and in the auricles, and what kind of blood will be there in the ventricles? So auricles always contains CO2 blood. Auricles always contains CO2 blood. So when you learn this, some of the common points are there. If you see that first common points, then a heart structure and function will be the easiest one. So upper chambers, both the auricles contain deoxygenated or carbon dioxide blood, and ventricles contains O2 blood or oxygenated blood. Okay. So now, from where this carbon dioxide blood and from where this oxygen blood heart is getting, after getting the blood, what it is doing? So as I told you, some common points. First of all, both the auricles receives blood from different places. So from where, we will see, auricles receives blood and ventricles sends away blood from the heart. So this is one common point. What is the common point? Auricles receives blood, both the auricles, whether it is left or right, and ventricles sends blood away from the heart. So from where they are receiving to where they are sending, let us see. Okay, another common point is, just a rough diagram, another common point is both the auricles receiving. So receiving always, receiving is taken by, receiving means brought. As I told you already, the circulatory system of the human beings, transportation, with the help of three things it will take. First of all, heart, pumping organ, it is a strong muscle. What is heart means? It is a strong muscle, pumping organ. What is the size means? Just one's own fist. How much is there? Okay, clenched fist. How much is there? That much will be there. And this heart has, second is, first organ is heart. Second is vessels, arteries and veins. Tubular structures are there. The tubular structures are called vessels. Either they are arteries or veins. What is the function of artery? What is the function of vein? We will see. And wherever they go, in the lungs or near the tissues, the arteries and veins divide and divide and divide. They becomes small tubes. They are called the capillaries. So what are the, are there? Heart, arteries, veins, capillaries. These are the structures which take the blood from the heart, and these are the structures which bring blood to the heart. Okay. Now, blood is the main. Blood, what does the blood contains? Yesterday I told you, plasma is there, the base substance. And in that, blood cells are there, white blood cells or red blood cells, but we don't call them blood cells. What do we call them? Carb cells. Why we call them carb cells? Because they are drowned, they are immersed in the plasma. The cells of the blood cells, they are immersed in the plasma. So that is why they are called blood corpuscles. Okay, now that is another issue. So here, receiving, heart is receiving blood from two different places. Okay, who are receiving? Only auricles receiving. So what is the common point here? Auricles are receiving, but different places. And bringing one, receiving means bringing vessel. Which vessels are bringing? Always bringing ones are called veins. Always bringing ones are called veins. Okay, now taking away from the heart. Taking away from the heart. Are called arteries. Okay, if writing is not clear also don't worry, copy everything is given. So receiving ones, heart receiving ones are veins. Only thing, you know one thing is, always arteries contain oxygenated blood and veins contain CO2 blood. But there is difference is there. One way correct, another way not correct. Okay, receiving veins. Now this right auricle is receiving blood. Okay, two small veins are bringing blood. Two small veins are bringing blood to the heart. Small veins are bringing. So this is, suppose this one, particularly this smaller vein which is bringing blood, if you see my body, from the lower part of the body. This one is the lower part of the body, it is bringing to the heart. And this is upper part of the body. So carbon dioxide blood bringing to heart with the help of two small vessels. What are that? One is from the inferior side of the body, that is why it is called inferior vena cava. Inferior vena cava. Vena cava. Okay. And from the brain and upper portion, that is the upper superior vena cava. Superior vena cava. Body is very small, very clumsy it looks. Okay, so two vessels are bringing blood to the heart. One is from the lower limbs and other, the lower part of the body, that is inferior vena cava. From the brain and upper portion of the body, that is the superior vena cava. And both the vena cava, CO2 blood, carbon dioxide blood, which is released by the cells and tissues, brought to the heart and pouring the blood into right auricle. So the vessel which is directly entering into the right auricle is called vena cava. This is one big vena cava that is divided into two, inferior, superior. That is vena cava, that is vein. What is it? Is big vein, vena cava. Okay, so the same time, so total carbon dioxide blood from the body is coming to the heart, to the right auricle, the same time, left auricle. So what is bringing here? Vein is bringing. And here, okay, carbon dioxide blood is in the vein. That is not an issue. Here, receiving left auricle. Left auricle is receiving oxygenated blood. Left auricle is receiving oxygenated blood from the lungs. From the lungs. Am I clear to you? So this lungs, what the bringing one is, which vessel is bringing? As I told you, common. Which is bringing? Bringing or receiving. Receiving one is vein. That means this is also vein. This is vena cava, big vein. And this bringing one also vein. This is called pulmonary vein. This is called pulmonary vein. So both the veins, this is also vein, CO2 bringing one also vein, O2 bringing one also, O2 bringing one also vein and CO2 bringing one also vein. So here previously CO2, that was wrong. O2, this is left auricle O2 blood. O2 bringing one is called pulmonary vein, and CO2 bringing one is called vena cava or big vein. Okay. So same time, both the auricles are receiving blood. One side, the right side is receiving through the vena cava carbon dioxide blood. Right side receiving from the lungs. Naturally, the blood went to lungs for what purpose? Blood went to lungs for the purpose of purification. So from the lungs. Left auricle is receiving what kind of blood? Oxygenated blood. So here, what are the common points? Both the auricles are receiving blood, and both the auricles are receiving blood with the help of veins. So oxygen bringing blood from the lungs is called the pulmonary vein, and this one, right side, carbon dioxide blood from the tissues and from the cells which is coming to the heart brought. So these are the two common points, auricles receiving, veins are bringing. Now, the blood from the both the auricles has to reach in the ventricles, okay? So now this blood is, carbon dioxide and oxygen blood is not mixing because of the septum, because of the separation here. And now this auricle, both the auricles sends the blood to the ventricles. Both the auricles sends the blood to the ventricles. Okay, so naturally, left ventricle receives what kind of blood? CO2 blood. Left ventricle receives CO2 blood, and right ventricle receives O2 blood. So left ventricle is getting the blood, O2 blood, to the left ventricle is getting the blood from the right ventricle, O2 blood, which came from the lungs. It is reaching to left ventricle. And right ventricle, CO2 blood is sending into, right auricle is sending into right ventricle. Okay. How it is sending? There are valves are there. Here, if you see clearly, there is two I showed you. Here, three I showed you. So, these valves are called cuspid valves. These valves are called what? These valves are called cuspid valves. So if you see here, two parts like that. If you take any two portions like this, if you make a small, okay, circle like that, you take this is a circle like that, circle center one point you make, this is two parts and one hole like that. So here, that is a circle like that, like this, and made into two parts like this here. So this is bicuspid valve. This is called bicuspid. Which side bicuspid valve? Left side is bicuspid. Suppose if you take the circle like that, means it is a cover. Cover means ducker like that. It is a cover, and it is having like this here the hole like structure. 1, 2, 3. Tricuspid valve. This is called tricuspid valve. This is tri. Remember cuspid swelling. Okay, bicuspid valve, tricuspid valve. So when this blood has to come from the auricles to ventricles, these valves will open. But these valves will open one direction only, to the from the auricle to ventricle. It will not open like this forcefully. If it is, otherwise they open auricle to ventricle direction, one direction. Okay. So through the valves, the blood from the auricles reaches to ventricles. Am I clear? So now carbon, what is the here common point? What is the common point for the ventricles? For the ventricles, what is the common point? Ventricles receives blood. Auricles receives from the outside and ventricles are receiving. What kind of blood it is receiving? Right ventricle is receiving carbon dioxide blood. Left ventricle is receiving oxygenated blood. Okay. So these are receiving from the heart chambers to here. Now these are the receiving is not common here. what after getting the blood, after getting the blood, the diagram will be somewhat difficult for you to understand. After getting the blood has to after the getting the blood, the ventricles sending away from the heart, auricles receiving from the to the heart, and ventricles sending away from the heart. That is many thing. So ventricles are sending. So sending through what? Definitely sending through some vessels. Which vessels? Arteries. Which vessels? Here ventricles. Sorry, here veins. Here arteries. Both the sides. Arteries. Both the arteries. Now you see here, one artery is coming from the right ventricle to. I told you diagram will be difficult for you to understand. This artery is taking the blood from the right ventricle to lungs. Where it will take? It will take to the lungs. What kind of blood? CO2 blood. Okay, so the blood which is taking from the right ventricle to the lungs, that is, it is called pulmonary artery. Pulmonary artery, which is taking, is called the pulmonary artery. One more point I will tell you. So now from the left ventricle, the blood has to, what kind of blood? Left ventricle, oxygenated blood. This oxygenated blood has to reach whole body. So from this left ventricle, one more vessel will come out. What kind of blood? Oxygenated blood. To whole body. Yeah. Now you see, both the ventricles sending blood away from the heart. So right ventricle is sending its blood, carbon dioxide blood, to the lungs. For what purpose? For purification. And here, from the left ventricle, oxygenated blood is going to the whole body. Purified oxygenated blood, it is going to the whole body, so the body is getting oxygen, and whatever carbon dioxide is produced during the process of oxidation, thus that blood is coming to auricle, auricle to ventricle, ventricle to through pulmonary artery. So pulmonary artery, where it is going? Lungs. For what purpose? Purification. So what, you got the common point here. Here you got the common point. Ventricles are sending away blood from the body to where? To two different places. Okay, two different places. One is the carbon dioxide blood from the ventricles. The blood is reaching to lungs for the purification. And left side, oxygenated blood is going to the whole body. Through what? Through both the arteries. This is called big aorta artery. Big, this is very big one and thicker one. And pulmonary artery, lungs are near to the heart only, so it no need of going very long distance place. But from here, from the left ventricle, with one push, the whole blood has to go to all cells in one time. With one push or one jerk, from this aorta, the blood has to go to all the cells. Okay. So here, with one push, it will go to lungs. Lungs are near only. So what are the common points? Here you may surprise why this pulmonary vein contains oxygenated blood and pulmonary artery contains CO2 blood. One thing you remember, Okay, now if you understand this, so actually this left ventricle, the wall of the left ventricle, if you see the wall of the left ventricle here, the wall of the left ventricle is thicker than the right ventricle because it has to use more pressure to send this only small chamber blood in with one jerk to the whole body. Then this whole blood entering into this vessel, this vessel means this aorta, and immediately reaching to, it needs very high pressure. This has to use more pressure. So the wall of the left ventricle is thicker than the right ventricle. That will be one more question. So now what are the recap common points? If you see, auricles are receiving and veins are bringing, ventricles are sending away and arteries are. So one thing is, remember the relation between the heart and the lungs, relation between the heart and the lungs, the vessels which you are taking and which are bringing from the heart to lungs, lungs to heart, is called pulmonary. And body to heart, heart to body, is called the systemic. First of all, here one more point I wanted to say, how the blood is moving from the heart to body, heart to lungs, lungs to body, lungs to, so how it is moving, how it is taking place. Actually I told you one thing, heart is a strong muscle. Okay, what is the character of the muscle? Muscle structure and characters you already have learned. That muscle always contracts, relax, contracts, relax. This is a continuous process. When it is contracting, the chambers will squeeze, the blood comes out. When it is relaxing, the chambers will open like that and blood comes into the chambers. Okay, so the contraction, relaxation, it goes on continuously. Heart contraction. Here one more common point is, both the auricles contract one time, both the ventricles relax one time. Both the auricles contract one time, both the ventricles relax one time. Both the auricles relax same time, both the ventricles relax same time. Okay, so that process we will see, that is cardiac cycle. Before that, I wanted to give you one more point, important point here. After that, if I have time, okay, otherwise next video. Next is double circulation. Okay, double circulation. So this double circulation, just I'll give you a small formula like that. Center you write heart. Remember this, how to write, because you don't get in this in book. Center heart. Heart is the pumping organ. Okay. Now the first method is lungs to heart, heart to lungs. Yeah. Now another one is body to heart, heart to body. From lungs to heart, what kind of blood will go? From lungs to heart, O2 blood, oxygenated blood, that is bringing, that is what? Bringing. Okay, lungs are bringing blood to heart. What kind of blood? Oxygenated blood. Who is bringing? Pulmonary vein. Okay, that is pulmonary vein. And heart is sending blood to lungs, that is carbon dioxide blood. Heart is sending blood, from where heart is sending. Naturally, this is from the auricles. No, this is through the veins. This is pulmonary vein. This is vena cava. Nahi. Heart is sending lungs. Heart is sending lungs is the pulmonary artery. Okay, now let us see once carefully. Lungs sending oxygenated blood to the heart. That is called pulmonary artery. Who is receiving? Left auricle. Okay. Next, heart is sending carbon dioxide blood through pulmonary artery to the lungs. From where? From the right ventricle. So this is one circulation. What is this? Is one circulation. And the relation between the lungs and heart, the relation between the lungs and heart is taken. That is the pulmonary. So this circulation is called pulmonary circulation. Okay, so what is pulmonary circulation? The circulation between the heart and the lungs. The circulation between the heart and lungs is called the pulmonary circulation. Okay, so blood is going from the lungs to heart. That is oxygenated blood. And who is taking that? Pulmonary vein, left auricle. And heart is sending the carbon dioxide blood, which is received from the body, sending to lungs for what purpose? For the purification. Who is taking? Pulmonary artery. From where? Right ventricle. This is one circulation. This circulation is called pulmonary circulation. The circulation is called pulmonary circulation. Okay. Now the second variety circulation. The second variety circulation, body to heart. What kind of blood will come? CO2 blood will come from the body to, then that is called what? Vena cava or vein? Big vein. Vena cava or big vein. So to where it is coming? From the body to heart means, and the next one is the heart to body. Heart to body, carbon dioxide blood, because this is the artery. This is artery or big aorta. Oxygenated blood, artery. So what is the second circulation? Body to heart, carbon dioxide blood, vein will take. And heart to body. Heart to body means from the left ventricle to whole body. Who will take? Aorta or big artery. So here oxygenated blood. This is the second circulation. This is what? Second circulation. This circulation is called systemic circulation. This circulation is called systemic circulation. Okay, so how many circulations are there? Two circulations are there. One is pulmonary circulation between the lungs and heart, and another is the systemic circulation, body and the heart, relation between the body and the heart. So what does it mean? The small heart, whatever heart is there, the small heart, it is sending blood away from the heart. Heart is sending blood away from it two times. Heart is sending blood from the heart two times. One time to lungs, another time to body. So two times it is sending away from it. So that is called double circulation. That is called double circulation. So what are the kinds of double circulation? Pulmonary circulation between the lungs and heart, and systemic circulation between the body and the heart. Okay, now tomorrow we will see third video, cardiac cycle.